Love your enemies. No, not in my radar, not on my in my wheelhouse. Why would I want to love my enemies? Because Jesus said so. There's a reason for it, obviously. And we'll get into that in today's episode of The Word, but I just wanted to kind of bring you into, like, what category when we're going over this topic. We are in the realm of outreach and service, and what better people to reach with the saving grace of Jesus Christ than our enemies? We'll get into this a little bit more in today's episode of The Word. Stick right with us. We will be, where am I? There. Right back.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path.
Love your enemies. Yeah, that's what Jesus is saying in our gospel lesson for this morning. And it's a wonderful opportunity for us to really dive in and to understand and to believe and to put into practice what Jesus is saying to us, even though this is highly irregular according to our human nature. Our human nature doesn't want to love those who don't love us. After all, why would I want to love somebody who can't stand me? Because it's the grace-filled thing to do. It's the truth. It is the life that God has given to us. Yes, it's a little challenging. But yet at the same time, it isn't, because that's what Jesus did for us. He loved us. We were his enemies. We who were his enemies at one point in time are now his friends because of what he did. He did, not you and me. Because of what he did for us is the reason why we are his friends and we are loved and we have been loved. So grab your Bibles, please. Whether you're using an electronic version or a paper version, we will start in Luke chapter 6. We're going to get right at verse 27, and we're going to go through verse 36. So grab your Bibles. We'll be back on the flip side. Okay. Luke 6, 27 through 36. But I say to you who hear, love your enemies, do good to those who hate you, bless those who curse you, pray for those who abuse you. To one who strikes you on the cheek, offer the other also. And from one who takes away your cloak, do not withhold your tunic either. Give to everyone who begs from you, and from one who takes away your goods, do not demand them back. And as you wish that others would do to you, do so also to them. If you love those who love you, what benefit is that to you? For even sinners love those who love them. And if you do good to those who do good to you, what benefit is that to you? For even sinners do the same. And if you lend to those from whom you expect to receive, what credit is that to you? Even sinners lend to sinners to get back the same amount. But love your enemies, and do good, and lend expecting nothing in return, and your reward will be great, and you will be sons of the Most High, for he is kind to the ungrateful and the evil. Be merciful, even as your Father is merciful. Yeah, he's pretty clear about it. I mean, there's no ambiguity here. There's no yeah, but availability here. It is clear. It is crystal to love your enemies. Why? Because we should. Jesus says we should. We should love our enemies. We should love, be in action of love. And if somebody is looking for something from us, give it freely. Because this is what we should do. Now, you've never hear me say a lot in the realm of should. Because it puts a different connotation on what we do as Christians. But in this case, I am going to use the word, this is what we should do. But I'm also going to get at the reason why. But I want to highlight, first of all, before we get to the reason why, I want to be able to highlight the simple fact that we don't. We don't love our enemies. We hold grudges. We get angry. We get frustrated. We get afraid. We are always putting up barriers and walls. That is what we do, not rather not what we should do. This is what ends up happening. And if you ever watch the news, and it's sometimes very depressing and very disheartening to watch it, but when you do watch the news, you will see more often than not, people who are doing things to their enemies because, quite frankly, they're my enemy, or not doing things for their enemy because they're my enemy. I am against them. They are against me. Neither the twain shall meet. We don't get along. We're not going to get along. I'm not even going to pretend to get along with them. All these other things that we use in order to put up walls, put up barriers, set up divisions that fuel our hatred, that fuel our anger, that fuel our fear. They just continue to multiply, 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 multiply. You know it's true because you do it. I know it's true because guess what? Yeah, I do it too. I remember saying in religion class and in chapel this past week for our elementary students, because we're going over the same passage. How could they not like you, Pastor Robert? Which is very kind for them to say, but then I had to explain it a little more fully, saying there people don't hate me because of who I am personally. They may hate what I do. And what I do is I bring the gospel of Jesus Christ, the life-saving gospel of Jesus Christ. I point out their sins and their sinfulness. I point at the reason why Jesus came. And there is where we are right now. Why should we love our enemies along with our friends? Why should we do it? Because Jesus did it for us. While we were still enemies, Christ died for us. We were enemies of Christ. We were enemies of God. We were enemies of the cross because we are sinful human beings. We have the instantaneous and instinctive and original sin-based animosity toward God. And God broke through that animosity. God tore down those walls, came to become a human being just like you and me, except for one key wonderful element. Because he was conceived by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, he is God. And God has no sin. And God came to earth, allowed himself to be tortured, allowed himself to be crucified, allowed himself to die, so that you and me would have life with him, to engage in acts of love. Because of what Jesus Christ has done for us, we also love. Yes, we love those people who persecute us. Yes, we love those people who hate us. Yes, we love those people who do things. And here's the context of love that I want to focus on most of all. It's agape. It is self-sacrificing. It is service-oriented. It is the reason why God done it, because he loves us. He loves us so much that he was willing to send Jesus to us. And this is the form of love. This is the form of love that we use when it comes to loving our enemies. This self-sacrificial love. Think about it a minute. Self-sacrificial. Self-sacrificial. What am I giving up? I'm giving up my animosity. I'm giving up my hatred. I'm giving up my sorrow. I'm giving up my grief because somebody else may have wronged me. Good. Because God gave you his life. And we'll end today there. But there's more to it, obviously. I'd love to see you in worship this morning, 10:30. We have our in-house service, and it is also live-streamed at the same time. Also, we are looking forward to seeing you in time of study this morning at 9:15. We have multiple classes. Don't want to get too much into advertising here, but join us 9:15. Join us earlier because we have a little bit of time with coffee and donuts, but it's a great time. Join us. Give us a thumbs up. Ring the bell. Share this wonderful video with your friends about God's love and grace for you and for all people. There we are. We'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.